our panel a little bit, but we also have some other artists here. We have Alison Oakes on the end. Alison teaches at Mississippi out in Knoxville. She's a Knoxville native, and her works are the oils on porcelain on the tile wall. And we have Tanya Tewell, and Tanya teaches down at MTSU, and the big painting back of Big Bang is hers, as is here in the orange. And we have Ruth Crnkovich. Ruth is not an artist, but she is an art consultant. She is president of CRN Fine Art Services, and she's a run for hire. She gets curates, she appraises, and she does a little bit of everything in the arts. And then we have Yvonne, I guess Yvonne is from Bowling Green, and Yvonne's works are the large green pieces with the women in the water. And her works are in collections all over the USA as well as Greece. So welcome, ladies. And I'm going to turn it over to Alison to kind of start.
Hi, thank you so much for coming. So we just came up with a couple of questions to kind of get our discussion started. So if you guys have anything you want to input or ask any questions along the way, please do so. So the first question that I came up with is, in most cases in history, men do the looking and women are there to be viewed. How do we feel about the role reversal that has taken place in contemporary art history with men, that women have made with men? And do we feel that we have a responsibility to portray ourselves in a different way?
I'm a professor and I run a model program and do a lot with the figure. And most of the time, if you say run a model, they'll assume female. And if you were talking art historically and you say an artist, the first thing that comes to mind is a male. So I don't think it's really changed as much. Like, of course, there's opportunity now and all that, but in terms of the assumptions that people come with, and I feel like it's my job as an educator to keep challenging all the time, not necessarily put female artists in front, but just keep to my students having variety with the type of artist, you know, things like that, to keep challenging the assumption that they might start with.
Naturally, as a woman brings something different to the table, your experience.
experience, all those other things that maybe a lot of women share, or maybe not just women, but a lot of people share.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
bring us to the second, the next question. I'm interested in the idea of the conversation of the male gaze, you know, been talked about for a very long time, and I'm interested in the idea of female gaze and differences in those, and that if the conversation of the male gaze is still something that's relevant to talk about in reference to the show. And again, with this idea, are we as female painters, especially if we're going to portray the nude or you know, something like that, do we have an obligation to deflect the male gaze, challenge the male gaze, comment on the male gaze, sort of have anything to do with that conversation? The works that I have here today, I don't know, are completely on point with it, but the work that I've been making for 3 years prior has been sort of to deflect the male gaze. I paint close-ups of my body, face, body, and I sort of do the compositions in ways which seduce. But when you get up close to the surface, there will be varicose veins, bruises, zits, hairs, all of that good stuff that would be sort of photoshopped out if it were an advertising image. And so the paintings sort of bring you in, but then kind of give you a little bit of a kick when you get really close. So that's something that I've thought about for a really long time, and I'm still sort of very interested in.
If you were here 2 years ago for our Women's History Month exhibit, you would have seen Allison's lips and her eye and that mascara. And I think it was a painting was
right. Yeah, it was a painting.
Yeah, I think the obligation was true. And I think that's what you're seeking when you give that close up. This is the truth. What you see from back here is not necessarily the truth. I mean, there was the obligation. And I think if the piece is dealing with specific issues that have to do with countering the male gaze, I mean, that's obviously what that statement is about, but I don't know that everyone has that same obligation.
Okay. Or is it something that everyone thinks about?
I like that you're engaging that question very directly, and both the experience for the viewer goes through steps to engage that question, and the cues in the work start to actually change the expectation, you know, the defense. I don't do that directly, but and I actually don't think of my images as an image, you know, but more a sculpted form and meaning that becomes in some way. So I don't think of the surface of her in that way, but I do try and use skin and the manipulation of painted skin into maybe the image of skin, but I think of it maybe a little more actual than that.
Yeah.
As holding history, holding, you know, like I noticed your bra strap embedded in the skin there. You know, for me that kind of stuff, it's the whole like when I mentioned abuse, you know, one way I use to describe my work is, you know, it's not about the hit or the action or the narrative of the actual event, but it's how it feels 10 years, 30 years later, you know, so that stuff is embedded in, you know, the body and the numbness absences that are there, things like that. So I have different cues that hopefully will trigger in whether it's a male or female viewer, maybe just a pause to think about those things. But so
you're using your application and your paint to do that. I can tell that a lot.
Yeah, the process of building, putting in, taking away.
The last thing that I wanted to talk about was this idea that people always say that all portraits are self-portrait. So even if the painter is painting someone else, there is some sort of part of themselves in there, the way that it's either portrayed or maybe it's an actual physical attribute. But that saying sort of always stuck with me, and it interests me a lot. So that was part of the question, is do you feel like if you're making a portrait of somebody else, that it has to, there's some part of you that gets put into it, and then the second part is, if you are making self-portraits, do you feel that you are trying to use yourself as an example of all women, or, you know, many other women
choose those particular women because of something in me that I relate to, you know, their posture or some expressions that they have or some power that it seems to be embodied within them, you know, that I really want to share that in some way. You know, I want to not necessarily glorify it, but somehow honor it, you know, by painting them in a way that I hope is unique. And I guess in that uniqueness, it's about myself that, yes, that's, but it's not, I don't know if it's direct, but I hate doing self-portraits for sale, but, yeah.
Just for the choice of people.
I think the creative process, any creative process, painting, or anything, I think you can only draw on what you know to be true, and what you know to be true are things that you've experienced. Before I had children, people could tell me what it was like to have a child, but until you know, until you experience it, there's nothing that can transcend that feeling, painting, poetry, anything. You have to experience certain things, and doing so, when you reference that, that becomes your vocabulary, that's what you're referencing when you're putting things out there. So I think everything, from the way we dress, everything is a self-portrait. Everything we do is a self-portrait.
My experience with that is I draw from models all the time, and I always make their eyes too close together, because I've heard those sentences.
Line in my work, but it sounds like you have a little more part of your
that answer anything?
Yeah, I would just, it's fine. I'm impressed.
We have Gwendolyn Rodriguez is here. Gwen has painted the woman, the right kind of woman washing her hair, and also the little girl. And Gwen wrote a great blog today talking about, thinking about why she paints what she does, and I thought maybe you could share that a little bit.
I know, I tried to put it in. When I paint a woman, to me, it's kind of like Plato, and I don't know if you're familiar with him, but he had an idea that there was an ideal that we couldn't see, like if there's a chair here, we can render that form, but there's really an ideal chair somewhere else that we can never totally capture, and every chair we draw is only part of that universal chair. So kind of to me, in a way, painting women is painting a whisper of Eve, and as that universal woman, and the fact that she represents to me beauty and truth, and I think that there's such a hunger for beauty in the world, and we see it falsely portrayed, you know, in exploitive ways of women. But there's still that's kind of an echo still of that hunger that we really do have for beauty. And so that's one of the main things that I see, and that's why I take certain pictures, because to me that's what it fulfills a little bit.